money and go get that car and all of that.
The polling district review is a statutory duty for the council, and whereas previously it's been undertaken every 4 years, with the last one being done in 2011, the Electoral Registration and Administration Act 2013 introduced a change to the timing of when the reviews should be undertaken, and it states that it should be started and completed between the 1st of October 2013 and the 31st of January 2015, and their subsequent reviews will be undertaken within 16 months beginning with the 1st of October of every 5th year after that, which would make it the 1st of October 2018. With the related canvas that we've carried out at the moment and all the major events taking place between the statutory time, it was decided that we would start the review at the earliest date possible, which was the 1st of October 2013. The review started on the 1st of October with a notice inviting interested groups to submit comments and representations by the 3rd of January 2014. The acting returning officer also submitted his representations, which were published on the 14th of November 2013. Appendix 1 that's attached to the pack contains a summary of the responses and recommendations. The first recommendation is for Heswell Ward, Polling District RD. The current polling place is St Peter's Centre in Liverpool. But concerns do persist regarding the parking facilities in the area. It was agreed on the 10th of November 2011 to move the polling place from St Peter's Church of England Grammar School to St Peter's Centre because of disabled access at the school was concerned to be raised more or less at the time it was in action. So we moved to the St Peter's Centre. It's located in the village at the bottom of the hill, and it's a suitable venue with good disabled access and facilities for parking is at a premium around the centre. This is a recommendation, a comment made by Electoral Services for your approval that the election probably should remain at the centre rather than reverting back to the earlier alternative, which was the school. Do you want a decision on that, or do you want me to
go through? Any questions on that?
Just a bit of background information. You're saying it was agreed to move the polling place from St. Peter's Church in the Grammar School.
The proposal was made by us and Councillor Peter Johnson. He tried to move the polling place for a number of years from the school because of the disabled access. The school, I don't know if you know the school in Heswell, you need to take a lot of steps up to get to the polling place, and the disabled access meant you had to go all the way around the back of the school, the room of the school, to get into the polling station. Whereas the centre in the village is completely disabled access, level access. It's great, it's a very suitable
venue. So there is parking for disabled people at the centre?
There are parking bays outside the centre, and we have an agreement with Highways to cordon these bays off and to allow do have other means of parking around the back of the church where the church allows us to use the church parking for election staff that they use.
Yeah, I think I know the answer to the question. I'm assuming the board councils are
there's been no complaints by anyone of the venue. It's just the concern to persist about parking. I'm conscious that in 2015 there is a parliamentary election, but if we anticipate an increase in parking, that there may be problems, we can try and rectify the situation for the election in 2015 rather than move back to the school.
Okay, any more questions? Is that agreed, that one? Okay, Chair. Right.
The next one is Lisa Morton East Ward, Holland District TC. The current Holland place is Eastway Primary School Children's Centre. Prior to this, it was Yew Tree Online Centre and Yew Tree Road. However, during preparations for the Police and Crime Commissioner elections in November 2012, it was discovered that the venue was no longer available for future use. And therefore, on the meeting in October 2012, the committee agreed to change the polling place from the centre to the primary Eastwood Primary School Children's Centre. But it should be reviewed for future elections. excuse me. Now, we've been in touch with Yew Tree Online Centre regarding use in the future, and where they've told us that it's no longer for sale and that it can be used, it's only going to be kept open if enough people use the centre. So, therefore, we're asking for the status quo to continue for us to use the children's centre at Eastway School, because we feel that the Yew Tree Online Centre is not a reliable venue.
Any questions? Nope. Not agreed.
North West and Sorbor Massey Road, Holland District YC. This is really just for your information rather than wanting any kind of approval. The current polling place is Foxfield School in Douglas Drive, and we've received communication from the Education Department that there's a possibility the school will be sold off in the future for redevelopment. We have subsequently found out that there are two schools that may be closing. No, two schools, one will close and merge with the other one, but we're not sure which one will be which. So it's just really recommending that the status quo should continue for the elections this year, but that it be reviewed for future elections.
Okay. Any questions?
Hensby and Thindle Ward, Polling District FE. Current polling place is Christ Church Hall and Marston Road. During the local government elections in May 2012, one of the candidates for the ward observed inadequate visibility of the access route into the site from Marston Road. The health licensing health and safety general purposes committee on the 9th of November 2009 resolved to create a new polling district, which we called FE, within the ward, and to use the Christchurch or Boston Road as the polling place. Following observations made by the candidates, we investigated it, but considered that it was still the best option for a polling place within the polling district. I think it was more about signage than anything, so obviously we're going to put it in place with the design of signage for that point.
Okay, any questions? Nope, not agree?
Do you agree?
more adjustment to the following district boundary between SB and SD. I don't know if you're aware that the polling station for polling district SD was unstable for a number of years due to the closing down Poulton Primary School, which was its polling station, and the merging of Park Primary School. Whilst Park Primary School was being redeveloped, they moved into the old Poulton Primary School site, but then with the intention of the polling station being the new Park Primary School site. It was then we discovered, once it was agreed by the committee to do that, that the school actually sits just over the whole of the district boundary of SD, and in fact is located within the whole of the district of SB. So we would like to move the boundary slightly so that it would encompass the whole Park Primary School into the whole of the district of SD. There are no residential properties involved in the move, so it wouldn't have any impact on the electorate.
Thank you. Any questions?
Just an observation, Chair, on that. I had to talk to the governor of the school, and we moved, as you know, can explain over the move and then I saw that coming, so we actually moved on the side of the boundary, we just slightly like outside the boundary. And we're running short in a matter of yards, metres, whatever you want to call them, aren't they? It's all on you. So, completely agree with it.
Any more questions? Is that ready?
Agree.
No?
Wallasey Ward, Holland District VP. Again, this is a request by Electoral Services. The current polling place is Mount Pleasant Primary School on Mount Pleasant Road. However, since it was agreed to use that venue due to All Saints Church Hall on Hillside Road closing, we've discovered that it doesn't prove satisfactory and is not the best option for the polling place in that whole district. Adjacent to the school is a new venue, a children's centre that has since opened. And we've visited the centre and we find it to be a suitable venue, good civic access and facilities. It also benefits from the car park, directly access from Mount Pleasant Road, the separate entrances and the exit gates. We would like the approval to move the polling station from the school to the new Bradford Children's Centre.
Any questions?
Through you, has the case since the Minister report, All Saints principle has been opened now?
Sorry?
All Saints has been opened now.
Yes.
To be acquired by the Liberal
organisation. Yes.
Has any field been given to move back to that physical energy so we don't disturb it?
We haven't. It was a decision we were going to make based on the outcome of this meeting, more so because there would be a cost involved. So if we don't have to look into it as a result of the result of this meeting, then that would be great. We don't agree to move to the Brighton Children's Centre, we would then subsequently have to look at the church. We haven't looked at the church. We didn't find that out until it's only really recently opened.
Okay, that's fine.
2A UP is moved to enable electors to vote at Luton Village Hall and Rachel Cross Lane, which is closer to them than their current home place, St Michael's Church Hall, Bradley Road. If you look at the map proposal 2, the A3 sheet shows the boundary highlighted in yellow. It would be moved, would be deleted. And the A4 sheet gives you a close up look at where the actual new boundary is would be. The move would then encompass all the even house numbers in Grange Cross Lane and numbers 73 and 75 Holland Road. These properties would move into the point of QP. On the appendix, you will see a breakdown of the number of electors and the number of postal votes. And in our opinion, it doesn't seem to have any significant impact on the number of electors in the Chicago district. So our recommendation is that the boundary be adjusted.
If I could just explain, it's only arisen since the polling, this polling place has moved from Corby Grange Man School to that polling Man School Lane to Bridge Hall, which has meant this logical situation where people living on the far side of Grange Cross Lane with two houses in Corby Road had to actually walk right past the Bridge Hall over the polling station on their way to Burbank City.
Okay, Jim, one more question. The recommendation agreed. Okay, that's it.
There's just one more, still within West Kirby and First Bristol Ward. This is Polling District QC. A council member has requested a change in polling place from St Bridget's Church in the Primary School to a new centre that has been opened adjacent to the school. The council member has stated that access to the polling station rolls along the road, partly down the steep slope from the nearest parking place, and at the entrance also lacks any court space for tellers. We've been to have a look at the centre adjacent to the school, whereas we do find it a suitable venue, a suitable alternative venue, there would be a cost implication, whereas if we remain at the school, we don't incur a cost for that. I might add that we have not had any complaints either from voters regarding the use of the school. So our recommendation is that the status quo should continue.
Councillor Ross.
Thank you, Chair. I did pass out a ratio of 4 sheets with pictures on the back and on the front. You can see that the way into this present school hall is down the sloping drive. And two sides of the building to get into the hall. Incidentally, this is a double polling place. It's the largest polling district in the world, so quite a lot of people go here. The last time it was used in an election 2 years ago, the church centre was just being completed, and people were arguing, it wouldn't be nice if we could go there. And while we said there'd be no complaints, those of us who've been at the polling station know how people struggle to get back up the hill afterwards, and we grumble. I'm sure if I thought about it, I'm going to put it back up to the place where I was in the meeting. They said they would like to move to the new facility, which, as you can see, is a much shorter walk than that. So we've got a lot of a very beautiful new building with that space outside the immediate public place.
Thank you.
As you said, the cost, I'm able to understand, would be around £770,000.
Yeah, the cost to us hasn't been determined, but you know, they have said that it's available, but they haven't determined the cost to us.
Sure. I've been quoted £17 an hour.
Any other questions?
What's the view of the school on the use of school in versus the cost of disruption of education model? Yes, it's a government, it's a possible station, but the government said we prefer someone else to use. Is this a fact?
Yes,
council all the time?
I did visit the school in the back of the lecture officer and when we went to the present place and held the confession while the school
you'll find that that is the opinion of those schools that we use as polling stations. But if we can accommodate another location within the school premises for the polling station, that will mean the school can remain open and we do so. Unfortunately, it's not always the case that we can. But you'll find that most schools would rather we didn't use them. However, the returning officer is well within his right to use schools within the area.
If I could just say, if you look at the plan, you can see this is the only public building in the whole business of the road. It's two buildings, in fact, and it's dead end. So everybody has to come up to St. Bridget's Lane or Ludlow Drive, get into the narrow end of St. Bridget's Lane and turn and head there. So it's very difficult for the school to cope with the election and parents coming in the morning, coming away down to do an outdoor parking and so on. That's what it's better for them.
To reinvestigate that many times that I'm outside. Mike?
Yes, Chair. Council orders determined that the cost would be about £270. I would have thought 17 hours, which must be quite a bit of a sanity back in the reduction. So it could be reduced.
Not necessarily so. I mean, the cost of hiring private halls for the use of elections ranges anywhere from £200 up to £700. And it's usually around the region.
So you're not agreeing with me? Am I allowed to propose that we do change the public space?
Of course you are.
That's what it's for.
Yeah, yeah, that's the
decision. The idea came to very far across.
Yes, I think that's a good idea. That's why I said we revisited it. And then when we can't, we never allow, we don't have time to do that. But can I suggest that the chair that you look at?
Obviously, time's a factor here because the elections are in May. So, when you want to end it after the election, before the election.
You're talking about another election this year, I think we have to do it beforehand, really.
There's no problem with that. The problem with that is I'm not aware that you're going to schedule a meeting today or agree it before the election. So I've just applied to attached having process where it goes away on time to cost and so happy with it. We have a meeting and agree before the election.
Mark, hello. I mean, normally this committee would meet again before the election towards sometime in March. I am not a definite date as to whether which date it is in March.
That being the case, then I'm not sure whether or not, like you said, if we have the time then it's when we decided not to change it. Yeah. But whether they would be able to then inform the electorate that it's going to be the change.
Well, time is on your side actually on this occasion because the election is later than the normal. Being on the 22nd of May. However, you weren't about informing the electors where their polling station is because the poll cards will be delivered from the 14th of April. Now, although the 14th of April is after the days of the next meeting in March, we do have to get our information to the printers in time for those poll cards to be printed.
Sure, could we originally agreed, subject to the
possibly not more land to be repaired?
The money for this election, the money the authority has to cover 50% of the cost of polling stations because it's combined with the European. However, if it was a standalone local government election, having a by election or if it's not combined with any other election, then the council would have to.
If you agree that we'll go ahead and buy tickets in order to be able to potentially do something in the £350, we still have to form the elections in the moment. It would be better to decide to accept the opposite level of the application this time if council was correct and there are lots of people potentially who are with the.
Thank you.